I'm back with my webpage about dogs that I'm slowly but surely turning into a webpage all about cats instead. Now, the next thing I want to do is to change all instances of the word dog into the word cat and leave the rest of the text the same. How could I do that? Well, we found the heading by ID, but we can't find these dog words by ID because there are multiple of them, and we know we can only have one element with a certain ID on a page. Well, let's look at what else is similar about them. Each of them are surrounded by a span tag, and for each of them, that span tag has a class of animal. So we could either find all the span tags or find all the tags of that class. And now I'll show you how to do either of those. Let's start with finding all the span tags using a new method, document.getElementsByTagName. Let's go down to our script tag and add a new variable, var name else equal. Notice I put an S at the end, and that helps remember that I'm storing multiple elements in this variable, not just one. Now I'm going to use the method document.getElementsByTagName. And now inside here in the parentheses, I need to pass it an argument, which is a string, which should be the tag name. And the tag name is whatever between the angle brackets. So in this case, the tag name is span. Beautiful. Now, how do I check if it works? Do you remember what we did before? Da-da-da, console.log. So we type console.log. And now before you check, let me tell you something about what you might see in your console. Different browsers will represent the elements in the console in different ways, since the variable that you're logging out isn't just one element. It's actually an HTML collection, which is something that's a lot like an array, and it lets you access elements by index using the bracket notation and find out how many elements are in it. So your console might show you something that looks like an array that you can expand and see all the elements, or it might show you something that looks like the HTML for all three. Now, pause the talk through and see for yourself what your console shows. Okay. So if you want, you can also log out each element in that collection by using bracket notation. So you could say name else 0. Just like arrays, the first element is at index 0. So we put 0 between the two brackets. All right, so hopefully you saw that step 1 worked. We found the elements. Now we want to modify them. You might try doing something like what we did before. Name else.innerHTML equals cats. But nothing happened there. That's because we've set the innerHTML property on the array of elements, not each element. So the browser ignores it. Instead, we need to use a for loop to actually get at each element. For var I equals 0, I is less than name else.length, I plus plus. That will go through all of the indices. And then for each element, we're going to say name else I dot inner HTML equals cat. Ta-da! We did it. The cat is now man's best friend. There's almost 1 billion cats in the world. Wowies. And this is why you should not trust anything on the internet, my friends. Okay, the part that worries me about this approach is that if there were any other span tags on the page, it would change those too. And span is actually a pretty popular tag to use for a variety of things. It would be safer if we just changed everything with the animal class name, because that seems to be much more specifically used only for occurrences of the animal name. So to do that, all we have to do is change this method here to a new method, getElementsByClassName. And then instead of passing in span, we would pass in the class name, animal. Ta-da! It worked, and we didn't have to change anything besides that line. Okay, remember, when you're using these methods, you have to spell them correctly. If you don't, You're either going to get an error or it just won't work. And I've seen hundreds of spelling mistakes with these names. Like this, that's not going to work. That's not going to work. Make sure you're spelling it correctly. And that's where console.log is super helpful to check that you're getting the expected results at each step. Also remember, getElementById returns only one element. And getElementsByClassName or getElementsByTagName return multiple elements, so we have to use a for loop to go through them. All right, you ready to get a few elements yourself? Go try it out.